Well, we come to Revelation chapter 12, and we're dealing with the woman, the child, and the dragon. And this is a challenging chapter. And if you ask me, have I got this thing fully under control? I still have a bit of wrestling with this chapter. And you'll find that as you get into Revelation, you've got to do a bit of wrestling. You've got to work on a few things. But I'm going to share it as accurately as I think I can. And so it starts off here and says, "Now a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon, and under her feet and on her head, a garland of 12 stars." Who's this? People say all sorts of things. How can we understand who this woman is, this sun-clothed woman? Let's read it again. A woman clothed with the sun, with the moon, and under her feet and on her head, a garland of 12 stars. Now you might say, how am I supposed to understand that? That's where we search the scriptures and say, okay, let's see if there's anywhere in the Bible that lines up with this particular piece of scripture. And if we go right back in the book of Genesis, and I'm going to take you back to chapter 37, and I want to read this scripture to you. There was a dream right in the beginning in the formation of a nation. And the formation of the nation was the formation of the nation of Israel. And we read that Joseph had a dream, and he dreamt that he was a sheaf in the field and that his brothers would bow down to him. The other sheaves would bow down. And then it says in verse 9 of Genesis 37, then he dreamed still another dream and told his brothers and said, "Look, I have dreamed another dream. This time the sun, the moon, and the 11 stars bowed down to me." So if we add this up, we've got 12 stars because 11 of them are bowing down to him. We have the sun, the moon, and 12 stars. And really, this is speaking of the nation of Israel. Search the scriptures. Here is your understanding of this particular verse in chapter 12. And so it is going to concern the nation of Israel. And it reads along this line. "Now, a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, the moon, and under her feet and on her head a garland of 12 stars. It's Israel. Then she, being with child, she cried out in labor and in pain to give birth." And the scripture says, "And another sign appeared in the heavens. Behold, a great fiery red dragon." 13 times in Revelation, the devil is mentioned as the dragon, the red dragon, having seven heads, which will speak of seven empires that precede the Antichrist. We could go into those seven empires, going right back to Babylon and following through through the, and probably including also Assyria and so on, going through. There are seven. We can look at them at a later time. 10 horns. We're going to find those 10 horns in the book of Daniel. We're going to find the 10 horns again in Revelation chapter 13. And these 10 horns are not crowned. These are 10 nations that will be given to the beast. So the beast or the Antichrist will actually have these 10 nations, 10 people groups or 10 nations that are under the beast. And there will be seven diadems on his heads. And so seven crowns, seven kingdoms preceding the eighth kingdom, which will be the kingdom of the Antichrist. There are seven preceding ancient kingdoms that precede the rise of the eighth kingdom, which is the Antichrist system. And so it says, "His tail drew a third of the stars of heaven and threw them to the earth." We do know that a third of the stars of heaven had already been cast out of heaven, but Satan has been the prince of the power of the air. He's there. He has been in that realm. And he still, I believe, is in that realm where he is still the accuser of the brethren. And so a third of the stars have now been swept down and they're actually on the earth. These are demons and fallen angels, if you like. And the dragon stood before the woman who was ready to give birth. Israel, the nation, is getting ready to give birth. And he was waiting to devour his child as soon as it was born. Now, is that Jesus? It's certainly, I have always sort of seen that as Jesus, how the devil was ready to kill him as a baby. But I've heard others speak that this is a male child who, and I've seen it as Jesus. How you fit that, I'm not totally sure. But other very top scholars, numbers of them, and I've looked at their reasoning, they have talked about it as being the male child or the 144,000 Jewish evangelists who will certainly have rulership for a period of time. It does talk about the male child who will rule all the nations with a rod of iron. I think this, it, to me, it really points more to Jesus, but there are those that teach that this is the rise of the 144,000. You think that one through and try to put this into place. And her child was caught up to God and his throne. Well, certainly the 144,000 are going to be taken up. They will be taken up in a rapture. We know, of course, that Jesus was taken up in the cloud. So you do your own thinking there and see if you can get an understanding of exactly who is this male child. But then it says this, and we are dealing with this very end of the age. We're dealing with the Antichrist. The devil has come with great wrath. And the Bible says that the woman, which is Israel, fled into the wilderness. So she fled, and this is at the time of Antichrist, into the wilderness, into a secret place. And the scripture says where she has a place prepared by God that they should feed her there 1,260 days, which is 3.5 years. And as you study Daniel and you also follow into Revelation, you'll find that these 3.5 years, which is, I believe, the second part, and I think it's the second part of the Great Tribulation, she is going to be hidden for those 3.5 years in a secret place where she's going to be nourished and looked after. Some people say, well, is that the church? No, it's not the church. And it'll become very clear. Here is protection. These are Jewish Christians, which we'll see fulfilled shortly. They will be kept nourished and protected from the Antichrist for 3.5 years in a wilderness place. Now, is there any mention of the church being protected? If the church was to go through or is to go through the tribulation, surely there would be mention of the protected place, that there would be a protected place. But the scripture doesn't talk about that. I believe the Bible clearly tells us that there will be a great catching away of the saints, the people that get converted and come to Christ during the tribulation. It will cost them their lives. But I believe in the great catching away, and that we will be taken out in the moment, in a twinkling of an eye. Then will come all the things that are happening on the planet. Will there be tribulation prior to that? Probably very much so. And people say to me, Tim, are you scared of persecution? Not at all. Not at all. Persecution doesn't worry me. There's a big difference between persecution. Persecution is the work of the devil against God and his people. And the great tribulation and the wrath of God is God's wrath directed towards the devil and his people. Now, I'm not one of that group. I'm one of the group that serve him and love him. And I believe that we will be taken out. I think the scripture is very clear on that. And then the Bible says this, and she'll be nurtured for 1,260 days. As you read Revelation, you'll find this 3.5 years coming up, coming up, coming up. Find it the same in Daniel. Perhaps later we could look at the number of times that the 3.5 years are mentioned. The scripture says there was war in heaven. Now, this is a significant war. This is not the original war when Satan was cast down. This is not going back right to the beginning when Satan was first cast out of heaven. He is now fighting in the heavenly realm, and there's a great war. Michael the archangel is fighting with him. There's a great battle, Michael and his angels. And so there's a huge angelic force fighting in the heavenlies with Satan. Who was Satan? He was an angel. He's not equal with God. Far from it. He was an angel, a fallen angel. He was the anointed cherub that guarded. He was the guardian anointed cherub who now is confronting other angels. And these angels fighting him in the heaven, they prevailed. And there's no more place for him now in the heavenly realm. And the great dragon, the old devil, was cast out. That old devil called the serpent, the devil, and Satan. So there's several of his names, the old serpent, the devil, and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And so very interesting here, he will be cast down, and the demons will be now on the face of the earth with the devil. No longer is he able to accuse the brethren. Let's have a look at that. It says that Satan, which deceives the whole world, he is cast out onto the earth. The deceiver, the accuser, is cast down. The accuser, the deceiver. A lot of people say we are now in the millennium. Well, I read in the during the thousand-year reign on the planet that Satan is bound with chains so that he cannot deceive the nations. And so the deception, Satan is the deceiver of the nations. And here, the deceiver is still in operation, but he'll be on the earth, not in the heavenly realms, in the spirit realms. He'll be on the earth, still be in the spirit realm, but on the earth, and he's coming down with great wrath. They are now on the earth, and he's still the deceiver. So we cannot be in the millennium. Some people are amillennialists and don't believe in the millennium. The millennium is mentioned six times in the scripture. And others say we're in the millennium now. Well, he's still deceiving. And if he's chained right now, he's got an awfully long chain. And then I heard a voice coming from heaven saying, salvation and strength in the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ, for the accuser of the brethren is cast down, which accuses them before our God day and night. He no longer is accusing at this point because he's cast down and he's on the earth. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, the word of their testimonies, and they loved not their lives unto the death. Let me pick this up here. I'm reading so much stuff here, I lose track of where I'm at. So let's pick this up here. They did not love their lives to the death. Therefore, rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell on the earth, woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you having great wrath because he knows he now has a very short time. And so he is going to unleash his wrath. And his one of his big aims is to take out Israel, to take out the Jews. One of his, he is angry now. He is especially angry towards Israel. Verse 13, now when the dragon saw that he'd been cast to the earth, he persecuted the woman who gave birth to the male child. But the woman was given two wings of a great eagle. Now, just exactly what that means or how this happens, only God really knows. But that she might fly into the wilderness, which was spoken of earlier, taken into a secret place. Now listen to this, where she is nourished for a time, times, and half a time, which again is 3.5 years. Time, times, and half a time is 3.5 years. The Bible says the serpent spewed water out of his mouth like a flood after her. I think it's a symbol or a picture of a great army going after her, fleeing after her to destroy her. But the earth helped the woman. The earth opened up its mouth and swallowed up the flood which the dragon had spewed out of his mouth. And the dragon was enraged with the woman, and he went to make war with the rest of her offspring who keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Wow. He wants to make war and he wants to attack these Jewish Christians who have the commandments of God. So they're keeping the commandments, the Jewish, and they have the testimony of Jesus Christ. But these guys are going to be protected, as it says, 1260 days or time, times, and half a time. It's a challenging chapter, a very challenging chapter, not an easy chapter, but if you follow the beginning and who it's being spoken of, which is Israel, and we find there that the Jewish Christians are going to be kept in a place, time, times, and half a time. Those that have keep the commandments, so they're still keeping the commandments of God, which means they're Jewish, and are written and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. They're protected, fed, nurtured. Antichrist is kept away from them for 3.5 years of protection. Pretty interesting piece of scripture there. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, I'd love you to hit the like button. You might not agree with what I'm sharing. You might say, I don't agree with that. You may agree with it. You may find some stuff here you haven't seen. Love your comments. Hit the like. Make some comments. Please make some comments. We'd love to hear them. And if you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscription up there and hit the bell. And we love it that you tune in with us. I hope that has been a help today. God bless you.